Hello guys, welcome back. In our previous video, I completed all these parts of the bow, if you remember. And in this video, I wish to make these parts here and also these over here. But I want to make this also. As you can see here, the bow is not painted. Here the bow is painted, and that's the problem. I have to paint the bow to be able to place that piece, or otherwise I'm not going to be able to fit any paintbrush on the top to paint everything that is below this piece. So as you can see, I have already painted the bow black. It looks even better. And now I'm going to paint, before placing any other pieces, the gold part that goes over here at the side. I believe in some point it's over here. It's more visible, the gold part. So I'm going to do that. For this I'm going to use this brass metallic paint. It's non-acrylic, not my paint of choice. I do not use non-acrylic this is acrylic color. I do not like to use acrylic colors, but I wasn't able to find the shade that I wanted in non-acrylic color, so okay, I ended up with this. This is from Revell, is number 92. So there was no point on filming how to paint the black, and of course there's no point of filming how to paint the gold stripes at the side of the black. So I will do that, and I will get back to you to do the rest of the woodwork at the bow. But for you it's going to be a moment in this video, for me it's going to be a couple of days. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. Guys, I changed my mind rapidly. I do not like the way the color lays on the surface. I don't like its texture. I don't like the shade goes on the black. So I'm changing. I'm not going to use this color. Let me find the gold shade that I like and I'll get back to you. And this is the color that I'm going to use. It's number 16, gold, non-acrylic, by Humbrol. So let me paint and I'll get back to you to do the rest of the woodwork. And like I said guys, for you it was just a moment, for me it was 3 days. As you can see, the gold is absolutely beautiful when you have black and gold mixed up. And the bow looks amazing already, but we have a lot of work to do, so let me gather my materials and I'll get back to you to continue. So guys, according to the plans, I have to place two pieces. These are prefixed. One, this is 102 number, this is 103. They do not match. As you can see, the 103 is a little bit smaller. So, first of all, the 102 piece must go over here at the edge of these rubbing strakes. As you can see, it's not a perfect fit. I have gaps, so I have to sand it down to make it perfect. Also, sand down this curve, so here you cannot see it. I have a small gap, but what seems curious to me, this piece must go like this, is that the end is here, you can see it. But according to the plans, then the end must be a little further than the second beam. So this means approximately right here. I find that hard to believe that this is a laser cut piece and it's so wrong. Okay, it's wood, I can fix it. So, first of all, let me try to make this piece fit exactly here. Also, as you can see, I have to have a small angle, so the sanding here must be with an angle. And of course, the lower piece that will go approximately here must be at the must be sanded as well. So let me make these pieces fit and I'll get back to you. Also guys, I've noticed that the pieces need, every piece probably needs some bending. So this is the piece, as you can see it is bended slightly to match the curves of the ship, also this part here, and this piece must be here exactly like this, exactly like this, and I have to cut this part here and also to sand it down, but first of all I'm going to glue it. Then I'm going to do some sanding. But I need probably not. I will have a problem to do some sanding later. So better to mark where to cut right now. So according to the plans is 3 millimeters to the left. No, something is different guys, let me show you something. Something is different to the plans. So here we are. As you can see, this piece goes up to the it's the last, it's the third one, it's the one for the third one. Let me see that again. Give me a moment. Ah, okay. It's right there. All I have to do is bend it a little more. So the piece is correct. The piece is correct. It was my mistake, guys. Just need some bending here at the edge. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. And I have it. This is how the piece looks now. Now I have to glue it. This would be a bit tricky because the area here is painted. Here I have a hair. So let's see how to do this. Definitely with cyanoacrylic glue. This piece is going to be painted black, so no worries about that. Here we need some glue. Alright, first piece is in place. So let me shape the second piece and I'll get back to you. This is the piece. As you see, it's shaped, also sanded, and this piece will be glued exactly between, we have four wood strips here, so this piece will be glued exactly below the second wood strip. Let's see. Glue. Let's see up to which point I must pour glue. Okay, up here. So I believe this surface must be sanded. Maybe I will use some small file to do that, because I need to plank all over the surface now, and I have to have a flat edge. So let me sand it and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I have to place this piece, it's 1x3, like this, all the way over here. It's not going to be hard, it just needs to be cut in a specific size. As I can see, the plans is going, this whole part is going to be painted black, so if anything goes wrong, don't care, I will use a wood putty. So for starters, let's cut the first one. Of course, it's better to sand the pieces, the entire piece before gluing. And this piece will need some cutting on the top after gluing. everything will need some trimming or sanding, but that's okay. So this, you get the idea. I will go this all the way up to some point over here, not all the way to the end, and I will also place some more over here at the top. I believe this is going to be reinforcement. So let me do that, do the other side as well, and I'll get back to you to show you the finished result. Guys, just a small remark before proceeding. As you can see, I've closed up the entire part. I haven't placed any of these pieces on the top yet. Here we're going to have to place some more of them. It's where the holes for the anchors will be. But I wanted to show you something that here you can see it's up to this point, but if you see here, it's all the way to the end. So probably this photo is to show you that underneath the two pieces, 102 and 103. So let me clean this up, sand it down, place the upper part, also the other side, and I'll get back to you. Now guys, before the finishing result, I wanted to tell you something more. As you can see, this part is done. For the moment, we have some more pieces to place, but for these pieces over here, you have to make sure that every one of them are equal, but everyone is equal to the other one. They must be exactly at the same length, because if you place them and they are in a different length, it will be hard to fix. As you can see, it's going to start over here exactly where the planks end, and will end up right about here where this piece ends. So it's going to be a big surface, and over here it's going to be hard to be fixed if it's not the correct and the same length. So let me place them. Nothing peculiar about gluing them, and I'll get back to you. And done, both sides. Let me remove the camera to show you. It's beautiful. Don't mind the figure, you know why I place it there in a moment. Just beautiful. So let me place the camera again. Now, next step before the final step of this video is to place a couple of brass 2mm wires that, let me show you, will go at the top edge here all the way up here. I believe, give me a moment, sorry guys, there, you have a better view. We'll start from here, we'll go all the way up, and we'll end up right here. And the other will start at the bottom all the way and will end up right here where this boot of the ornament is. The ornament is not glued, it's just there to make some pencil marks, and I'm going to remove it. Here you can see I have some pencil marks where the boots are, so I can make the wire to be at the right spot. So let me get ready for that, and I'll get back to you to do it. So here I have the 2mm wire. So before continue, I have to bend it. I will start here, make all my way over there. I don't believe it's going to be at the end. I'm going to need a bigger piece. We will see. So guys, this is going to be very time consuming. until I get the bending and the curves right. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. So guys, look how much I had to bend it. I believe I have it. Like this, I'm going to need another piece over here, but that's easy. First of all, let's make sure that the upper piece is flat. Now, let's glue. This is going to be a little bit tricky. Okay, let me glue that and I'll get back to you. And the first piece is glued. Also, I added an additional part over here because the length wasn't enough. So let me do the other one and I'll get back to you. Very, very hard, guys, and very time consuming. And I have done only one side. I need to do the other one. So this concludes our today's video. In the next video I will finish the bow and I will place also some rails here. It's the part, that one, number 72, that I have skipped. So also everything here needs painting. Probably I won't do it because I have to paint also the rub extension, so I will do that only at the time, when the time is right. So guys, thank you very much for watching. See you soon with the next step.